Time to explore MZed, online courses for filmmakers.
The Cinema 5D virtual show is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video and photo solutions. Tilta, arm your camera. Blackmagic Design, creating amazing solutions for film, post-production and television. And Fomex, devoted to remarkable light.
Hi guys, I'm Johnny from Cinema 5D, and I'm here with Scott from MZed. Scott, how are you?
Good, thanks Johnny, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you very much. And I'm actually catching you at home in Sydney, Australia.
That's right. The beauty of the internet, I guess.
It's very, very nice to talk to people all over the world. That's one of the benefits of doing a virtual show. But we are not here to talk about Sydney, although it's a beautiful city, and we are not here to talk about weather. We are here to talk about MZed. So in a sentence, what is MZed? And then I will go back because I want to learn a little bit about you. So what is MZed?
Sure. Well, MZed, I guess, is almost like an online film school. So we're online education for filmmakers. We've got 30 odd courses on there now, hundreds of hours of video from cinematography to audio engineering, directing, screenwriting, kind of any kind of craft within filmmaking.
So just a little bit about you. First of all, I have to say that you are one of the partners of News Shooter. This is another site, an online magazine that also bring news to people. Actually, the people behind News Shooter are all professionals and very good friends, and you are one of them. But so you have two hats. One is being a co-partner of News Shooter, and the other hat is MZed. But yep. Are you a production person, or are you a businessman? How would you define yourself?
I'm definitely not a filmmaker in a traditional sense myself. All our content I've watched through. Firstly, I've been in the industry for kind of 15 years or so. But I've been, I would say, a movie fan and a film enthusiast all my life. And that's how I kind of got into it. I'm certainly not a tech head. I understand cameras. I understand the theory and stuff like that. I'm not really at home behind a camera.
And the idea to start MZed, where did it come from?
So I didn't start MZed, actually. MZed's been around for over 50 years. It was founded in the US by a gentleman by the name of Monty Zucker, who was a portrait photographer, I guess, started in the 1960s. Very legendary guy, if you kind of know that time and still photography. And he, was very into education. Obviously, fast forward kind of 40 years and the 5D Mark II changed all our lives and our industry forever. At that time, MZed kind of transitioned into filmmaking because their core audience of photographers wanted to learn how to shoot video on the cameras they had.
So when did you get involved with MZed?
Originally, I was at Rode Microphones. So I was in the marketing team there at Rode for maybe 10 years or so. We sponsored a lot of MZed Productions workshops in the US. And they were fantastic, things like Vincent LaFerre's workshop, Alex Borno's workshop. They were really, from Rode's perspective, there was so much educational content there. So I got to know the organization. And then when I left Rode, a few years ago, I started working with MZed, and then now I'm kind of running the show there.
There are a lot of educational platforms in the market.
Yeah.
Some of them doing everything from online cooking to online swimming, and in between you have filming.
Filmmaking is something that lends itself to education online. It obviously has to be hand in hand with practical experience. You can't substitute that, but filmmaking as a craft is something that to a large extent you can learn a lot of it through online learning. In terms of the different kind of platforms that are out there, from free stuff on YouTube to Lynda to people like Masterclass, We feel that we fit into a really nice gap.
How do you choose the tutors for the courses?
It's a good question. It's probably the hardest part of my job, is finding someone. Firstly, obviously they have to be someone who's educationally minded. You know, they have to have a passion for education. They have to have a passion for sharing their knowledge. So you can have, you know, there's plenty of incredibly gifted filmmakers that just, you know, they're not interested really in passing on their gifts. They're just interested in, you know, okay, what's the next project that I'm doing? And there's not to say there's anything wrong with that, but there's obviously a lot of filmmakers, or the people that we need to partner with are people that are really geared towards that and have a passion for sharing that. Then the next thing is, okay, can they articulate that education on screen? So they need to have a certain charisma, and obviously feel comfortable in front of a camera, not just behind the camera. And then the last really kind of part of that is, you know, are they an authority on the subject?
You just said charisma. I lost the chance to be a tutor of one of your jobs. Yeah, I'll try harder.
We'll talk after we go offline.
With my broken English, who wants to listen? Yeah. Anyway, that's a reality. So I understand that it's not so easy to find tutors, and you have specific requirements. Anything that you're cooking right now in the sense of new courses? Because we know some of our colleagues, if it's Philip Bloom, actually there are quite many that did nice things for you. What are you working on right now?
We've got more things in the pipeline than we've ever had before. And a lot of that has to do with the current situation with everyone at home. A lot of, you know, obviously most people in our industry are struggling to find work. You know, even our educators, most of them have reached a point where a lot of their jobs have disappeared. So it's an opportunity for us at MZ to kind of say, hey, look, what projects have we been talking about? What projects have we been thinking about? And what can we execute under the current lockdown conditions? So we do have probably about 6 or 7 courses in pre-production, some already in post. So even as soon as next week, we've got a new course on the C500 Mark II, which is more a technical kind of camera course. We do have, you know, our mutual friend Ollie has shot an in-depth color correction and resolve course. So that'll be coming out likely next month. And then we have we've got a really big editing course coming from an Oscar-winning film editor. So that's something exciting, maybe hopefully towards the end of next month.
When we talk about the situation, about the current situation, do you see some increase in consumption of your content?
Look, obviously there is. I think it's a great opportunity that we have as MZ to offer that to people. I even if it wasn't the business that I'm in, obviously education is a great thing to be doing right now, investing in your career, investing in your craft, and how are you going to make yourself better for that time when everything changes? And, you know, you can hit the ground running and, you know, be a better version of what you were offering prior to the current situation. We are in this position where people are focusing more on what we do right now because they've got that time. You know, what can we do to kind of help that environment? So the first thing that we're doing this month, we're offering what we're calling get one, give one promotion. So anyone that joins our membership, we're also giving you a second free membership that you can gift to a friend, a colleague, you know, a fellow filmmaker from the other side of the world that you know, anyone that might need a boost or you think that could do with, you know, the positive influence of MZ education. And then the second thing we're doing, which we've been doing through probably about a month now, is we're donating 20% of all sales to LA Food Bank and their efforts to kind of help those in need from the current situation in LA.
Very, very nice. I mean, educational and charity, yeah, obviously, and that's what you're doing right now. And obviously, it's extremely, extremely important. Scott, before we wrap up, anything I forgot? I do feel that I feel a bit more knowledgeable about you and the business, but if I forgot anything, that's the time. It's now or never.
Not really. I mean, I really want to say thanks to you and Nina for the opportunity. You know, I felt sad that I was going to miss catching up with you guys in Vegas around now. So it's good to be able to catch up online at least.
I think we found a cost-effective way to stay in touch.
It's okay. Okay. It's harder to share a beer though.
Absolutely. Scott, thank you very much for being with us. It's always a pleasure to talking to you. Guys, thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.